Good morning everyone. I hope you all are fit and fine at your homes. So students, our chapter number 12 is going on, that is our environment. And till now we have discussed two important types of pollution, which are air pollution and water pollution. Today we are going to learn about the land pollution. Students, as you all know, land is a habitat of us, means human beings and other animals and plants. But we are directly or indirectly damaging our land. So today we are going to learn about the causes of land pollution and its effects on the environment. Okay, so let's start today's class. Students, before starting today's class, I want to discuss something with you all. As you all know, our country, India, is all set to celebrate the completion of its 71st Republic Day on 26 January, right? But students, do you know why do we celebrate Republic Day? And why do we celebrate Republic Day on 26 January only? No. So today, I will tell you why do we celebrate Republic Day on 26 January. Okay, students? So students, Republic Day of India is celebrated on January 26 every year since 1950 to mark the day when the Constitution of India came into effect. Yes, the Constitution of India, which was adopted on 26 November 1949, but it came into effect on 26 January 1950. Now students, you all must be thinking, what is Constitution, right? So students, the Constitution is the supreme law of India. It's a document which describes the rights and duties of its citizens and the way in which it is governed. Students, the Indian Constitution is the longest in the world. Yes, it took around 2 years, 11 months and 17 days for the assembly to finish writing the entire constitution, and that too handwritten. It clearly states what power the government has over the citizens as well as the rights and duties of the citizens towards the country. Okay? So students, this Constitution of India was adopted on 26 November 1949, but it came into effect on 26 January 1950. And students, that is the reason why we celebrate India's Republic Day on 26 January every year. Okay? So now I hope you all have understood why do we celebrate Republic Day. Now what you have to do for the Republic Day? Students, I am giving you a topic and you have to write few lines on the given topic. And the topic is Know Your Constitution. Students, I have explained you what is Constitution. Now, you have to write few lines on the Indian Constitution. And then, you will click a picture of your work and send it to me. Okay? And students, remember one thing. The last date to submit your work is 26 January. Okay? Now, students, let's start our today's class, and today we are going to discuss about the land pollution. So students, what is land pollution? Yes, dumping of garbage and waste material on land or underground in a way that can contaminate the soil and the groundwater is termed as land pollution. Or simply we can say, land pollution is anything that damages or contaminates the land. Students, this garbage decays and becomes breeding ground for rats, mosquito, fly and other disease carriers. And it also becomes a source of unpleasant odor. Odor means smell. They also pollute underground water sources. Understood everyone? Now let's learn about the causes or sources of land pollution. So students, sources of land pollution are agricultural residues like pesticides and fertilizers.
Students, regular use of pesticides and fertilizers decrease the fertility of soil and thus resulted in land pollution. Okay, students, next source of land pollution is dumping garbage in open. Yes, students, dumping garbage in open gives unpleasant smell and becomes the breeding place for rats, flies and mosquitoes. Next is deforestation. Yes, students, cutting of trees to meet the needs of growing population leads to deforestation. Yes, students, another cause of land pollution is cutting down the trees. Students, trees have not only oxygen, but they also contain fertile soil. And when people cut down the trees, they remove this fertile soil. And without this fertile soil, the earth can't grow. So that's how cutting down the trees cause land pollution. Okay? Now, next cause of land pollution is industrial wastage. Students, as you all know, to meet the needs of growing population, more factories are set up and that produce more wastage, which leads to land pollution. Okay, students? So these are some causes of land pollution. Now, we are going to study the effects of land pollution. So, students, dumping of waste matter leads to formation of highly poisonous chemicals. These pollutants seep into the soil as well as groundwater resources and affect the life around. Yes, students, pollutants from the land seep through the soil and enter the groundwater. And this pollutes the groundwater too. Okay, students, next is excessive cutting of trees means deforestation also lead to soil erosion. Because of soil erosion, the top fertile soil gets polluted, making it unfit for further cultivation or for the plant growth. Also, many illnesses arise due to intake of fruits and vegetables grown on polluted land. Okay, students? So, these are some effects of land pollution. And I hope you all have understood what is land pollution, what are the causes of land pollution, and what can be the effects of land pollution. So, students, now let's revise it again. Yes, students, what is land pollution? Very good. Dumping of garbage and other waste material on land or underground in a way that can contaminate the soil and groundwater is termed as land pollution. Okay, now what are the sources of land pollution? So, students, the sources of land pollution are, first one is agricultural residues like pesticides and fertilizers. Next one is dumping garbage in open. Third one is deforestation, means cutting down the trees. And the fourth one is industrial wastage. So, students, these are the causes of land pollution. Then we have discussed about the effects of land pollution. So, students, the effects of land pollution are, first one is pollutants from the land pollutes the groundwater. Second one is deforestation leads to soil erosion. Next is the pollutants from land reduce the fertility of soil. Next one is many illnesses arise due to intake of fruits and vegetables grown on polluted land. Okay, students? So, these are the effects of land pollution on the environment. Okay, students? Now, you have to do this work in your notebook today. First of all, write down today's date, chapter number, and then write down multiple choice questions. And question number one is, smoke from burning garbage contains, options are, A, carbon dioxide, B, carbon monoxide, and C, oxygen. So, students, the correct answer is option B, carbon monoxide. Now, question number two is, soil erosion takes place due to option A, cutting of trees, B, animals, and C, factories. So, students, the correct answer is option A, cutting of trees. Now, the last question is, dysentery and typhoid are caused because of option A, drinking polluted water, option B, eating stale food, and option C, drinking soft drink. So, students, the correct answer will be option A, drinking polluted water. So, students, do this work in your notebook in a very neat and clean handwriting. Okay? And that's all for today. Thank you and have a nice day.